Maybe you've eaten inside Cinderella Castle, went to Epcot's Food and Wine Festival, and gone behind the scenes in Magic Kingdom, but you aren't a real Disney World pro until you've done the things on this list. Being a Disney pro doesn't just mean knowing all the insider info and best seats on each ride. It's also about all those little rites of passage, like getting locked out of your room at 2 a.m. or uncovering dozens of magic bands or old paper fast passes in your junk drawer months after your last trip. You can be a Disney pro if you've got the knowledge, but you aren't a true Disney World pro until you've done these. Now, of course, every Disney World pro has missed a reservation. You know that you can start making advanced dining reservations at 6 a.m. online 60 days right now before your arrival. And you know that it's advance and not advanced dining reservations, right? You know that restaurants like Cinderella's Royal Table will book up right at the 60-day mark, so you're ready and waiting to reload the page to get your choice of reservation times. You also have probably ended up missing or running late for a dinner reservation that you swore you'd have enough time to make it to after riding that one last ride in the park. By the way, it's usually Splash Mountain. But you also know how to fix this situation, right? You are a Disney pro. You've already called the restaurant and let them know you're running late or altered your reservation in the My Disney Experience app if a later time was available. Or if you're someone who's chronically late, like myself, maybe you've decided to forego making reservations in favor of seeing what pops up on the walk-up waitlist or dining at lounges that don't need reservations. All right, now all Disney World pros have gotten locked out of their rooms. Can you truly consider yourself a Disney pro if you haven't dealt with the pitfalls of a Disney trip? Maybe you're like me and have gotten locked out of your room at 2 a.m. because your magic band is no longer synced to your door for some reason. Now, you can go all the way to the lobby and have a cast member help you troubleshoot, or you can try opening your room with your My Disney Experience app on your phone. As a pro, you know there's a feature right in the app that will unlock your door with your smartphone. Always make sure everyone's magic band or key card works when you check in. Triple check if you have multiple rooms that everyone's band opens the correct door. Also, something I always do before we leave the room the first time, I will just stand outside and check all of those magic bands to make sure they open up the door, because the worst thing in the world is coming home in the middle of the night and not being able to get in your room, or coming back from the pool and not being able to get in your room. That's the worst. Because then you know you're walking down to the front desk in your bathing suit. All right, Disney pros have all waited a full hour for a bus and then fell asleep immediately when you got on board. There is something quintessentially Disney about that quiet, or hopefully quiet, bus ride back from the parks at the end of the night where everyone starts to fall asleep, even the adults, especially the adults because they've been toting kids around all day. And then you pull into your hotel and the driver flips the way too bright lights on. Memories, yeah? Now, at the end of the night, you might be waiting a long time to get on that bus because everyone's headed back at the same time. And maybe you're looking to fall asleep in your bed, not in a plastic bus seat. This is why a lot of the pros take ride shares or drive themselves now. It's all about getting somewhere on your time. You can use Uber or Lyft to get anywhere on Disney World property, or even for a Target run if you need to pick up some essentials. Just download the app, and if you've never used it before, you may be able to score a great new user discount. And some pros who have seen the fireworks a million times even leave the park a little bit early so that they can be the first one on that bus back to the hotel. Oh, hey, how about that? If you're a Disney pro, you've seen the fireworks show or parade before, and you know that lines for rides get shorter while everyone else is staking out a spot and watching the show. Fireworks are great and definitely worth seeing even if you've seen them before, but you know what else is great? Getting to ride Seven Dwarfs Mine Train in 20 minutes rather than 75 minutes. So if you're okay with missing the fireworks or missing the parade, those are great times to ride those super busy rides that you maybe didn't get a fast pass for. Now, all Disney World pros have waited in a really long line for merchandise. Yep, all of us Disney pros have got that one piece of merchandise we can't help but buy. Maybe it's Minnie ears or spirit jerseys, wishables, popcorn buckets, or those awesome tiki glasses from Trader Sam's. Some of those things can be really hard to get your hands on, which is why you've probably also waited in a pretty obscenely long line to get your hands on them. Remember those lines for the 35th Epcot anniversary merchandise? Oh my goodness, those were insane. And yeah, man, you know I have that t-shirt in my drawer. Now, we've seen hour-long lines for exclusive popcorn buckets and staked out a spot in line hours ahead of Trader Sam's opening so that we can get those hitchhiking ghost tiki glasses. To the uninitiated, waiting that long to pay loads of money for a Disney souvenir seems ridiculous. And maybe it is ridiculous, but when you gotta have that Santa alien popcorn bucket, you just gotta have it. Leave me a comment if you can relate. Keep an eye on DisneyFoodBlog.com. We'll let you know when there's some new exclusive merch coming out so that you know how, where, and when to get it. All right, Disney pros have also gone to a park and not ridden a thing. This one is going to make no sense to anyone who isn't a Disney pro, but I have done this so many times, gone to a park and not gone on one single ride. Now, this is usually the lucky purview of locals, people who live in Orlando or live in Anaheim and can just walk into a park and have a Mickey bar and ride Spaceship Earth and maybe have some dinner and then go home. And it's just like, you know, you and me going out to the movies or like going to the Applebee's for dinner or whatever, right? That's like what it's like for them. But if you're a Disney pro and you've been to Disney World many, many times, then sometimes if you have a park hopper ticket, you can go into a park and not necessarily ride everything on a Dumbo or Die schedule. Now, do we recommend burning a day on your ticket to just pop into the park for a few minutes? Absolutely not. This is mostly going to be the purview of annual pass holders. But there are times when rides are not necessary to enjoy your day in a Disney theme park. If you're going to Epcot during a festival, well, there's plenty to do that isn't riding rides. There's so much food to try, and during normal times, there are demos and seminars, concerts. You might not even have time for rides when you've packed in everything else. And of course, I sympathize with you pregnant mamas out there. When you feel like you can't do anything in Disney World because everything is advised against for those who are pregnant. But believe me, you can have a great time at a Disney park even if you're not able to ride Test Track and Splash Mountain and Big Thunder and Space Mountain and all of those. There are still plenty of rides and there's still plenty of fun to be had. All right, all you Disney pros, I know you've been mistaken for a cast member. We know directions to everything and what time the 3 o'clock parade is. While our information can be helpful, at least I hope it is not always the best thing to be mistaken for a cast member, but it has happened to members of our team. We may be able to answer a lot of your questions, but at the end of the day, cast members are going to be able to answer more of them. That's who we go to with our questions, and we always have a lot of questions in our line of work. It might be our encyclopedic knowledge of the parks or that our outfits sometimes unintentionally look like we just fit in with the cast members, but real pros have probably dealt with this mix-up at least once. And I know you Disney pros have posed for the ride camera. Your days of unanticipated ride photos are over if you're a pro. You know exactly where every single ride photo camera is on every single ride in every park, and you play it up to the camera when it flashes. Now, real pros even know where the photo is on rides that have two separate ride systems. Like if you go into Space Mountain, you know where the camera is, whether you take the left side or the right side, right? And you've got the poses down and your whole crew is in on them, so you got some hilarious photos floating around your My Disney Experience account. If you have some great ride photo poses or, you know, group poses that you guys do, let us know in the comments. You can always ask a cast member where the cameras are on the ride so you aren't caught off guard. And another pro tip, ask cast members that are taking photos around the park if there are any magic shots nearby. Disney has certain areas where you can take photos that will give you special effects, like zoom shots in Galaxy's Edge or in front of the castle. 360 shots are ones where a character may show up once you've gotten the digital copy of your photo. A lot of people don't know about these, but the pros sure do. Now, speaking of rides, Disney pros have also waited even longer for a ride than they have to. Here's why. You've ridden every ride multiple times, you know where all the best seats are. Now, you may not be able to make special requests right now since it makes loading the rides a lot more difficult and time-consuming, and cast members are already super stressed out with the current status of everything, but in the normal times, you're happy to wait a little longer for Section B1 on Soarin'. You know the wilder ride on Big Thunder Mountain is in the last car, and that you want to sit on the left side of your Splash Mountain log to stay dry. You'll often need to stand off to the side for another ride cycle after you nicely ask the cast member for your preferred seating location, but the pros know it's worth the extra time spent in line. All right, how many of you Disney pros have worn a costume in the parks? Now, adults can't wear costumes most of the time in a Disney park, only for parties and special events, and the rules still prohibit long capes, full costume masks, and weapons. Normally, only kids 14 and under can wear costumes, though we did see Magic Kingdom relax this rule last Halloween season, This year, we expect the rule will only be relaxed for the Boo Bash, the after-hours Halloween event. That doesn't mean you can't Disney bound, though. What is Disney bound, you non-pros may ask? Well, it's basically channeling the style of your favorite character into some more typical clothes, like wearing red, yellow, blue, white, and black to dress like Snow White. If you're visiting Star Wars Galaxy's Edge, there's a whole lookbook to help you determine if your outfit is okay to wear in the parks. Note, full Stormtrooper costumes are on the no list. Okay, Disney pros, how many of you have found a drawer full of paper fast passes? We've all got a junk drawer or three at home, right? Well, if you're a Disney pro, yours are probably filled with old magic bands, like the first edition ones where the little Mickey doesn't pop out, coasters from Jock Lindsey's Hangar Bar, swizzle sticks from Trader Sam's, old park maps with rides that don't exist anymore, paper fast pass when you had to get your fast passes in person on the day of from a kiosk near the ride. If those magic bands are causing too much clutter, you can bring them back to Disney and they'll recycle them for you, but let's be real, all that stuff is staying in the drawer because memories. Or maybe you're the creative type that's made a display for your stuff, to each their own. But if you do have a whole bunch of fast passes, I bet you can Etsy that stuff like crazy and make some really, really cool crafts that people will buy. All right, I know you Disney pros have gotten up super, super early just for a ride, right? The real Disney World pros will remember the way things used to be before you could make your Fastpass reservations from the comfort of your home and before you could snag a Rise of the Resistance boarding group from then. No, you pros remember the mad dash to Toy Story Mania in Hollywood Studios when that was the new It ride and Fastpasses would be gone crazy fast and you had to get there before park opening and be ready to make a run for the kiosks and the ride. And more recently, many of you remember the 4 a.m. wake-up call to make it to Hollywood Studios in time to grab a Rise of the Resistance boarding pass, battling terrible Disney Wi-Fi and the fact that it is literally 4 a.m. and the sun isn't even up and you haven't had your coffee. Maybe you've attended a ride opening and camped out at the park entrance. Only the diehards are gonna do that. Things have gotten a little easier, or at least easier to get a little more sleep in the morning, which really is a blessing when you're hauling around 10 miles a day in the Florida heat. You'll still want to plan to get up early if you want to see and do it all in the parks. They typically open a bit before the posted opening time, and you may be able to get on a ride before it's officially supposed to be running. Make sure you're at the park at least 30 minutes before opening. That doesn't mean pulling into the parking lot then. That means being at or through security and ready to enter the park as soon as they let you. You can knock out quite a few rides if you show up first thing in the morning, and that will immediately make you feel like a pro, even if you aren't one yet. Now, if you've made it through this video and are thinking, why would anyone want to be a Disney pro? It sounds like a bunch of waiting in line and uber amounts of planning. Well, we also know all the under-the-radar places to get the absolute best food, all the ways to get on rides faster, and how to do things with little to no planning. There's two sides to the coin, but even if you spent way too long waiting on a Disney bus, you've learned those hard lessons and you're more knowledgeable now. So use some of that knowledge and drop your favorite tips in the comments to help others on their way to becoming Disney pros, if that's really what they want to be. And if you're a Disney pro, definitely let us know. Thank you guys for listening. Thanks for watching. Thanks for sitting through our little fun times of reminiscing. As always, this is AJ for Disney Food Vlog, and we'll see you real soon.